Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade with a new tutorial in the Coding Fundamentals in GML 2.3 series. And in this tutorial, we're finally going to get to talk about structs. This is going to be part one, but there will be at least two more videos on structs. You can think of structs as either a container of variables or as a lightweight object. We'll talk more about each of these ideas in a moment, but let's talk about how you create structs first. So there are two ways to make structs. You can use struct literals. Using struct literals is simple and straightforward, and you can create it directly in the code that's running it. We'll see a couple examples of this, but it's very similar to how you create arrays with array literals. However, the more common way to create structs is with a struct constructor. This requires you to code the constructor separately, but once you have that, the constructor acts as a template that allows you to create as many structs of that kind as you want. And there's even inheritance built into these templates, so you can have a struct which inherits from another struct. And this is very, very useful. So here's an example of creating a struct with a struct literal. You can do it in one line or over multiple lines. The one line version would have open brackets, then the name of the variable, then a colon, then the value, comma, name, colon, value, and so on. And an example of this would be A, colon, hello world, B, colon, goodbye. And I'm using strings here, but these could be numbers, other data types, arrays, instance IDs, any type of data that GameMaker supports. However, as you might expect, this can get really long. So it's very common to create structs over multiple lines. This form is really identical to this form. So you have the open brackets, name, colon, value, comma, name, colon, value. Or a struct equals open brackets, A, colon, hello world, B, colon, goodbye. So these are struct literals, very similar to array literals, except that you have the value name, then a colon, then the value, rather than just the value. Struct constructors look like this. They're a function where you use the keyword function, then the name that you want to use, then any arguments you want to pass in, and then the keyword constructor. You can also do this in an unnamed version, which you'll see when we switch over to GameMaker. But the simple version is that they follow all of the same rules that you have when you make a function, whether that is a script function or a method variable, except that you have to use the keyword constructor after the function. The other important difference is that when you are using constructors, you use equals, not colon. So this difference is very important to keep in mind. If you're using struct literals, you need to be using the colon. If you are using a struct constructor, you are using an equal sign. To use this constructor or template, you use it much like you would a function, except that you need the keyword new. So if this were a pure function, you would just say my struct and then pass in the arguments. But since it is a constructor, you would say new my struct and then pass in the arguments. Note that there's no return value here, but this does return a new struct and assign it to this variable. Again, the two key things to remember with a constructor is that you make them just like functions, except that you have to add the keyword constructor. And when you actually use them, you need to use the keyword new and of course assign the struct that they return to a variable. So now let's talk about accessing data in structs. To access the data, you use the dot notation, just as you would for an instance of an object. You can also use with and then the struct ID. So, for example, if we created a struct with our struct constructor and we wanted to access value A, we would use astruct.a, astruct.b. Or we could use with a struct and then we can access the value directly, exactly as we could if it were an instance of an object. But with that, let's jump over to GameMaker and go through a couple examples. So up here, we have struct literals. We can create one in a single line, or we can create one over multiple lines, which normally you do by making line breaks after the comma. You can also use struct constructors. The first type we have is the function or the script function constructor, then the name of the constructor, then the variables we want to pass in, and then constructor. And then we simply assign the passed in arguments to the variables that we want to. And I want to point out that while I use underscore in my arguments, this is a convention that I have, it's not required. You also wouldn't have to have the arguments match the name of the variables, though I think you normally would want that. We also have the method variable of the constructor. And again, I want to point out that constructors are a type of function that return a struct. They're basically a template for making structs. And as such, most of the things that are true about functions in general are true about constructors in general as well. You can make global unbound script function constructors. You can make method variable constructors. You could put this in a script asset as it is over here. I could also have declared it over here. And then that constructor would be a method variable inside of this object and could only be accessed by instances of the object. So we have our two constructors and we can use them here to make new structs. Once again, note the keyword new. This is very important. If you don't add the keyword new, GameMaker won't crash, but it won't give you the results that you expect. And then we have accessing the structs. So one way to access a struct is with the dot notation. So here we're saying struct a.num. That would be this value right here. Struct b.num. That would be this value. Struct c.num. And that would be this value right here. You can see it would come in be 42. So we should expect 0, 10 plus 42 is 52. So a number should hold the value of 52. Then you can also use the function with a struct ID. And this will switch the scoped inside of the struct, so you no longer need to use the dot notation. Again, just as you would expect if a struct were something like an instance of an object. And we can say num plus equals other.aNumber. So we can add the number inside of this struct, which will be 625, to this number, so 52. So that should be 667. And then, just like you could with an object, you can actually declare additional variables inside of a struct. So even though struct D doesn't have the variable, another number in it, we can declare another number and assign it a value. And I want to point out one other thing down here. Note that we have to use other to access the instance of this object. So this struct, struct D, does not have access to the variables held in this object, or the instance of this object. So you have to use the keyword other, just as you would expect. And then to access the variable inside of a struct, you use the dot accessor. So here you can actually see that we're chaining these together. We're saying other.structA.num. So we go from inside of struct D to inside of this instance to inside of struct A, plus other struct B, num. And then just to show that this is working, we can use the show debug messages down here, and that will be it. Let's run this in our debugger. So here we are running it from inside of the debugger. You can start stepping through things. We have created structs A and B. I do just want to have a short side note. At the time that I'm recording this video, the debugger in the current version of 2.3 has a couple issues. Most of these appear to be fixed in the beta version that is currently out, and presumably will be pushed to the main version by the time that you're watching this, or at least shortly thereafter. But it does mean that we might get a few weird things while we're stepping through this code. But you can see that we have struct A, struct B, both with the same values as we would expect. Now we're going to declare these two structs with our constructors. So we're using the script function and then the global method variable. But as you can see, they have created the structs exactly as you would expect. Now we're going to access the values internal to these structs and add them together, assigning the result to this variable, a number, 52. Now we're going to switch scope to struct D, but this is one of the problems with the debugger right now. It's not actually going to update the variables inside of struct D over here. Again, this is fixed in the beta version and will presumably be released soon to the main version. But we will go in, we won't be getting any errors, and then we can just use show message to show that they have in fact been updated, 677 and 10. So now struct D actually has two variables, one of which we created inside of this with statement. So thinking of structs as containers, you can see that they're kind of like arrays or maps that you can create directly or with a template. Where creating directly is using struct literals, and the template form is the constructor. You can store any type of data in them, and then you can access that data and interact with it using the dot notation. And of course, you can pass the reference to the struct around, just like you can with arrays or other data structures. So that's the first concept of structs that I'd like to get across. Structs are very similar to arrays or any other data structure. You store data in them, and you can get and access and interact with that data. Except, and this is the key point, structs have their own scope. And this is where thinking of structs as objects is helpful. Variables can be named the same as the instance that holds them. There is a list of forbidden variables, and I'll have a link to that below. But this means that you can have an X or a Y in a struct, and it won't conflict with an object's X or Y. You can also bind functions to them, and then when the function runs, it will run as if inside the struct, accessing the struct's variables. And in this sense, structs are really functionally indistinguishable from GameMaker objects. Now, obviously, there are many differences. They don't have any of the built-in variables. They don't have any of the built-in events. They don't run any code except the code that you tell it to. You can't interact with them with functions like place meeting or anything like that. But in the sense that they have their own scope and you can bind methods to them, they are really like lightweight objects. But that's going to be the subject of the next tutorial. In this one, I just want to summarize that you can create structs with struct literals or constructors, where constructors are like a template that allow you to pump out structs in a certain form. When you are using constructors, they require not only the keyword constructor in the function, they also require the keyword new when you're using them. You can access data inside of a struct with the dot notation or by using with. And most importantly, Structs have their own scope. As always, the links in this slide will be below, along with the link to the slides themselves and the source code. And that's it. Thanks for watching.